Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 7. This is Section 2.2, Problem Number 7. It says a Math 19 class at PCC has students with the following ages shown below. Create a stem and leaf diagram for these ages. So you have a group of different ages, you know, a lot of 18 to 22, and then some others, you know, older, which is typical of what you'd see at BCC. This is a realistic problem. So the stem and leaf plot, it's gonna be sort of like a bar graph with some digits in it for the bars. So we'll make a vertical line. That's a stem and leaf plot. The lower numbers start with the first digit of 1. So that's going to be the first stem, and then the second digit is what they call the leaves. So as I look through, 18 seems to be the youngest age. So I'm going to start with that. The first leaf will be 18. So 8, let's see how many times it occurs. So as I go through, here's an 18 in the first column. 19, I'll get this in a minute. I want to put the leaves in order. Here's another 18. Here's another 18. Here's another 18. It's not a bad idea to leave yourself a little bit of space between the numbers to the right of the vertical line, just in case you see that you've missed one, you want to come back and squeeze it in. If you put it too tight, you can't do that without kind of making a mess out of it. And it's good to take your time, be careful, cross stuff off after you use it. And it looks like there's one more 18. So now the next one in that top row are going to be the 19s. So none here. Here's a student who's 19. So that's going to give me a 9. Here's another student who's 19. Another 9. Here's one that's 19. One more 9. And that looks like all the students that are under 20 that would have a teenage age. So the 1 is the first digit, and these are the second. So we have an 18, another 18. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 students that are 18, 3 that are 19. So the next stem will be a 2 for students in their 20s. So now you want to list those digits in order. So I see a lot of students in their 20s. I'm going to start just with the 2 zeros first. So I see some in their 20s. I'll come back and get that in just a minute. So nobody in the first couple of columns is 20. Here's a 20 right there. So let's take that, put in a 0. I'll get this one in a minute. Here's one more that's exactly 20. So 2 zeros. So now I'll look for students that are 21. Here's a student who's 21. So I put just the 1 because the 2 is already accounted for here. Here's another 21. Put a 1 again. And no more than a 21. So now I start with the 22s. Nobody in the first column, nobody in the second column, nobody in the third column, nobody in the fourth column. The last column, I have 2 students that are 22. So I'm going to put in a 2 for each of them. That takes care of 22. Now, next would be 23. Any students that are 23? No. 24. Yes, there is one that's 24. So again, I'm still in line for the 20s. That was 24. Any more 24s? No. So next would be 25. I do have a 25 right there. So again, the 2 in that 25 is accounted for here. They call it the stem. The 5 is what they call the leaf. That's the name, stem and leaf diagram. Any more 25s? No. So next would be 26. Any students in this Math 119 class that are 26 years old? No. Next is 27. As I look through, no. Next is 28. Yes. So, and that was the only one, one at 28. Next is 29. Here's one. Put a nine. And that's it for students in their 20s. So now the next stem will be a three for students in their 30s. So any students that are 30, don't go right for the 31. Don't forget, you could have a 3-0. And no 30s, no 3-0. So next 31, I can see the first column, there's nobody. The second column, 31, there is one, so I have the three, there's the one. Again, still looking for 31, no. 32 is next, as I look through, no 32. 33 is next. Again, you want to systematically go through. I mean, I saw one here, but you want to look at everything. So 33, there's only one. So I put a three. 34, no, no, yes, there's only one. So 34, again, I have the three, here's the four. That means it's 34. And that's it for students in their 30s. If you look for anyone else in their 30s, there's no one left. So we'll go to students in their 40s in this class. We'll start with a 4. Again, see, I see a 44 right away. Don't grab that first because you want those digits to go in order. Look for 40 first. I don't see 40. Look for 41 next. I do have a 41. There's the 4. There's the 1 for 41. Any other 41s? No. Any 42s? No. 43? No. 44? I do have a 44. So again, I'm just picking up the second digit of 4 because I have the first one already accounted for. 45, there's only one 40s left, which is 46. So again, I just put the 6. And after that, there's only one student left that's 53. So I put the 5 there and then the 3. When I see there's one left, I don't have to start at 0, 1, 2, 3. Like in the 20s, there were so many, I really wanted to take my time. Only one student in their 50s, so I could just see that what was the last one left. And that's the stem and leaf diagram.